welcome back to my channel. Please like, share, and subscribe so I can continue doing these videos. Thank you.
You can find me on all social media by Paranormal Geek.
Hi everyone, this is old, but I thought this was really interesting to make a quick video on. Of a CEO found dead inside her car in San Jose after 5 days research revealed her daughter's last phone call. She had a manic episode. She was saying that the Matrix was real. Parents of Irene Valenti, a Utah taxi CEO, was found dead under mysterious circumstances this weekend. Believe their daughter suffered a manic episode shortly before she disappeared, telling them during a phone call, "It's all a game. We're in the Matrix." I thought this was really strange. They don't want to say, or they don't have any conclusion of how she died, which makes it even stranger. Here are some of the... Many of you have seen that the search for Irene has been called off. While we were praying for a different outcome, we are so appreciative for the help and support you have given. Please remember Elon as the beautiful, smart, funny woman that she was. I don't have any details that have not been in the media. I'm sure that Harrison will thank you himself when he is able, but please be patient. Once she located the gray Nissan Murano, she stayed on the phone with her mother and father, where Valentin's conversation began, veering from the strange to the downright bizarre. Her father, Joseph Valentin, says his daughter was talking a mile a minute and wasn't making any sense. Though the behavior bereaved father insists that his daughter has no history of mental illness. Joseph says he wasn't the only member of the family to receive a confusing and disjointed call in hours leading up to her disappearance. But he also called her mother on and off for several hours across Monday afternoon through the evening. Her thoughts were discontinued. She said her thoughts were discontinued. She'd say, "I'm coming home for Thanksgiving," and in the next she was saying, "She's in the Matrix." I have told her mother, "It's all a game. It's a thought experiment. We're in the Matrix." That creeps me out so much. A 33-year-old who would be turning 34 on Wednesday missed her flight later that evening and failed to show at a summer ceremony in Utah on Tuesday, where she was due to receive a Woman in Tech Award. Concerned for her well-being, Valentine's husband Harrison Winston, a psychologist, attempted to track her location through a Find My Phone app, but was unsuccessful. That was her. She looked normal and God bless her. Once she located the green sign, she stayed on the phone and began fearing from the strange to the downright bizarre. Her father, out of the mall, and then it wasn't making any sense. I don't like the fact that her husband is a psychologist. But I'm not saying anything. Though the bereaved father insists that his daughter has no history of mental illness, no substance to the only member of the family received a confusing on them, just repeating what they said earlier. During her final phone calls with loved ones on Monday, I mentioned like low on gas and all that. I mean, it doesn't make any sense. This is strange. Frustrated with the police department, because Winston set up a help find. Oh, is this the same? No, this is like in 2019. Inspiring more than 1,500 Bay Area locals in searching. And I'll put this link down in the video below so you can read further into it, but I'm just doing this quick little video so you could see it, because I thought it was so interesting and strange. I feel bad for her, but that's really weird. Many of you have seen that the search for the one's called off on it. That's what they said earlier. Authorities have not yet released a time of death or offered any indication as to how long she was in the car before being found. A spokesperson from the San Jose Police Department also refused to identify a cause of death. When questioned, citing an ongoing investigation. The news of the Valentine's family are questioning how the police department handled their daughter's missing person care, accusing them of watching the search. This is really interesting. Joseph Anthony continued to despite the name of the woman. Authorities have not yet released the time of death or offered an additional unless they're still. Yeah, ongoing investigation. That's probably why they don't want to release cause of death. That's still strange, though. Okay, that was it. So, similarly, Weston took to Facebook to refute the department's plain writing. I would like to emphasize how out of character this would be for Erin. While she is adventurous, she is not foolhardy and would never intentionally be out of contact with her family. As a psychologist, I am especially concerned about her last calls, which is confusing and disjointed. Weston continued that it's completely possible to have suddenly. Why is he saying it can be of a manic episode like this? Or better than employment for some reason, even if they have not previously. It's supposed to work in the moment. That is so sus. Anyway. After news of her death, is made public to which he has wanted to let young woman remember as a special woman that lived in prison. That was it. I made a quick short video. I'm not into true crime stories or anything, but I thought that was strange that she would say the Matrix is real. This was back in this is the UK, and this was back in October of 2019. So go ahead and look into it. There's probably videos on this, but I thought this was so strange. God bless her heart, and I hope they find justice. Subscribe. Hit a like, share if you like the video. And hopefully I'll be making more videos. Thank you for watching. Bye.